Hey guys, back with Anton, and I'm Justin Moore from Parabolic Performance and Rehab, and we are now going to show you another example of a 90-90 activity that we can use to drive triplanar trunk movement. So what we're going to have here is Anton, again, in 90-90, left heel is on the roller, only to give him a little bit of a reference to that left heel, not necessarily to just aggressively dig down in. So I want full foot against the wall. First thing he's going to do is reach those knees towards the ceiling. He's gonna keep his back flat on the ground. Anton, you got hamstrings? Good. He's gonna squeeze the ball to get inner thigh. Okay. So now what I'm gonna have him do is I'm gonna have him reach his right arm up over his head. Okay. All the way to the floor, just let it hang out. Now, keeping his hamstrings on, I'm gonna have him give me a breath out, long, slow breath, and fog up glass at the end. Good, keep going, Anton, keep going, keep going. You got a lot more, keep going. Reach those knees a little higher. Good, and you can see the ribs drop down in and back and disappear into his abdomen. Now, after a long pause, about a 5-second pause, he's gonna silently inhale through the nose. And then he's going to exhale again, and we're gonna drop those left ribs especially down in and back even more, okay? With a long, slow, slow exhale with fogging up glass at the end. Now, what this is doing is because his arm is overhead with good pelvic position, we are driving frontal plane movement again in the trunk. So by side bending to the left, we are helping his left abs pick up leverage to be able to drive the ribs down in and back into internal rotation. When the left ribs are in internal rotation and he then keeps them there and takes a breath in, a silent breath in, he's going to fill his right apical chest wall with air and his right ribs are going to externally rotate. When that happens, we are driving right trunk rotation. So we are getting triplanar, sagittal, frontal, and transverse plane movement through the trunk just by reaching overhead and by manipulating airflow and the position of the rib cage. Okay. One key point before we finish. When Anton exhales, he is trying to definitely get left ribs to drop down in and back, but he's also trying to get right ribs to come down a bit too. We do not want to just throw the arm overhead and completely lose that right side ribcage position. Let the airflow open up and externally rotate the ribs, but we always want to keep a relatively good position with active abdominals so that we can have them eccentrically contract when he inhales to help open up the ribs without losing a zone of apposition. So give me one more good exhale, Anton. Good. And if we needed to, we could do this for both sides, but understand that there are asymmetries in our anatomy that dictate that we are going to mostly do this with our right arm overhead for a person who has a hard time getting a left zone of apposition and expanding a right apical chest wall.